The Illuminati. What does the Illuminati mean to you? Do we have an Illuminati on the planet today, in any shape or form similar to what was formed purportedly in 1776 by Adam Weishaupt in Bavaria in Germany? Illuminati, what does the word mean? Does it just allude to a group of people with a lot of money and influence in politics and controlling people perhaps on more mundane levels, or is there more to the story? If we look at Bohemian Grove, for example, where wealthy, influential people may meet in secret somewhat, we see rituals being carried out there, and I would suggest that the rituals are part of the magical side of things. And magic is practiced within societies to this day with secrets, and they remain secrets. Anyway, I will now read out of Furze Marish's book, The Ritual of High Magic, from page 16 and across to page 17, to try and add just a little bit more depth to what the Illuminati could be and what it means to be sort of, let's say, high up and really involved in the Illuminati and to be an illuminated person. So I will just read. Extrasensory perception. The method of developing extrasensory perception is by the stimulation and training of psychic nerve centers which function in certain points along the spinal column. These nerve centers are generally called chakras or vortices of force. They are nerve centers which many occultists are able to feel operating in their own bodies under certain conditions. These nerve centers are 7 in number and connected by etheric force to the line of the spinal column. They extend to the root center at the bottom of the spine, to the pineal and pituitary glands in the head, or rather the etheric centers which animate those glands. They are shown in diagrams in chapter 2. The root center is the storehouse of energy in man as an earth creature, man's link with the creative forces of Mother Earth. This force from the root center is drawn up the etheric spine in 7 waves, vivifying the other centers. When this force has awakened the pineal and pituitary centers in a certain manner, extrasensory perception results. The general flow of these forces is shown in accompanying diagram, figure I. It will be noticed in diagram, figure I, that there is a center of magnetism radiating up from the top of the head. This same phenomenon is observed on a greater scale as far as the Earth is concerned in the name Northern Lights or Aurora Borealis. A similar principle seems to be operating. The exact method of awakening this power is never given out publicly because it is dangerous in the hands of those who are not morally developed and quite selfish. I think it reads unselfish, but I think we mean selfish. Anyway, reading on. Possession of this power gives its owner tremendous advantages over other men. Considering the amount of exploitation which the leaders of the world openly practice on those weaker than themselves, it does not need much reflection to see why such psychic powers are not made public. Chaos would ensue if large numbers of greedy and selfish people possessed highly developed powers. The method is, however, taught secretly to those who fit themselves for this knowledge by lives of unselfishness and service. In ritual, certain nerve centers are stimulated. Now, we could read on because there are lots of bits and pieces to talk about, but one thing that I suspect is that particularly within the entertainment industries and banking industries and elsewhere, that when people sort of get to a certain level of influence, that they may be kind of ushered into or sort of co-opted into certain secret societies in a way, and magic may be demonstrated to them on certain levels, and it's shown in their work here and there. But it's just a thought, so I just thought I would read that passage out because it alludes to people within the Illuminati having the means of extrasensory perception and using this extrasensory perception to wield power and influence over other people within society.